नमस्कार, मेरा नाम आशुतोष बहुगुणा है और मैं एज ए साइंटिस्ट डी इंडियन कंप्यूटर इमरजेंसी रिस्पांस टीम में कार्यरत हूँ। इस सेशन में हम चर्चा करेंगे वेब एप्लीकेशन सिक्योरिटी पर, जिसमें हम देखेंगे वेब एप्लीकेशन अटैक्स एंड वेब एप्लीकेशन हाउ वी कैन सिक्योर द वेब एप्लीकेशंस। सो इन दिस सेशन द ऑब्जेक्टिव इज़ द टू लर्न अबाउट वेब एप्लीकेशन सिक्योरिटी इशूज, हाउ द अटैकर्स कैन कॉम्प्रोमाइज द वेब एप्लीकेशंस। देयर आर ए फ्यू मिथ्स अबाउट द वेब एप्लीकेशन सिक्योरिटी, वी विल लिस्ट देम एंड डिस्कस देम, देन फाइनली वी विल सी द काउंटर मेजर्स, हाउ टू प्रोटेक्ट आवर वेब एप्लीकेशंस। सो वेब एप्लीकेशंस, वी कैन सी द डेफिनेशन हियर। सो वेब एप्लीकेशन जनरली पोर्ट 80 पे, जो कि HTTP, और पोर्ट 443 जो कि HTTPS के लिए स्टैंडर्ड होता है, पे चलती हैं और एक्सेस होती हैं। सो वेब एप्लीकेशन इज़ अ सॉफ्टवेयर एप्लीकेशन दैट इज एक्सेस वाया ए वेब वेब ब्राउजर ओवर अ नेटवर्क और अ इंटरनेट। सो दैट्स द वेब एप्लीकेशंस। वी सी दैट ऑन अ डेली बेसिस, यू फिल अप सम फॉर्म, यू सी द वेबसाइट वेब एप्लीकेशन ऑफ वेरियस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, द इंफॉर्मेशन इज अवेलेबल दियर, यू प्रोवाइड सम इंफॉर्मेशन टू द वेब एप्लीकेशन, यू गेट सम इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम द वेब एप्लीकेशन। सो वट इज द वेब एप्लीकेशन सिक्योरिटी? सो वेब एप्लीकेशन सिक्योरिटी इज द सेफ गार्डिंग, प्रोटेक्टिंग दैट वेब एप्लीकेशन अगेंस्ट द साइबर अटैक्स, सो दैट हैकर कैनॉट कॉम्प्रोमाइज दैट एप्लीकेशन और मिस यूज दैट वेब एप्लीकेशन। Since this web application is accessed over the internet, the malicious actors, hackers, can compromise or misuse the web application. So that's why the importance of a web application security, which is safeguarding the web applications. So why the web application security is a challenge? Or we can ask a question, why web application is a favorite choice of a hackers or attackers? So in this example, if you will see, this is my valid email ID, but can you read it? No, but it's valid for a computer program. There is a program to decode that, and it's valid for it. In a similar manner, the application, web application, especially the application developed for your own or your organization, so that cannot be protected by any add-on security. So suppose we will say that we will implement the intrusion prevention system, parameter security devices and firewalls. So those things can have a limited impact on the web application security. The reason is that those devices are not tuned and cannot protect the web application device designed and developed for the purpose of your organization. So those applications are custom developed applications. Those applications is developed by you for your business, for your purpose. So that's the issue. We have to take care of the security of that web application. If there is a weakness, vulnerability in a popular applications, popular servers, so those vendors will release the patches and the updates for. But who will release the patches for the web application developed by us? It's our responsibility of an organization, owner of that web application. Another issue is in web application is the security is not priority. So generally we develop the web application with a thought that, okay, we need these features and these functionality in an application, and we never consider the security in the coding, security in the design. So that's the another issue, that's the challenge in protecting the web application. Then there are different types of web application attacks, the way and the manner in which hacker can compromise your web applications. So you can visit the Open Web Application Security project, that's OWASP.org, and there are details like a OWASP security testing guide, OWASP top 10 are available there. You can go through different attacks, different threats to the web applications and how we can improve the security of the web application. In this session, we will discuss some of the attacks on a web application, popular attacks like a cross-site scripting attack, SQL injection attacks, cross-site request forgery attack, remote file inclusions, command injection attack. So there are many, but we will, in this session, we will discuss only these few attacks. So what is a cross-site scripting? So cross-site scripting or XSS is an attack on a web application when the web application, without validating, reflect back the user provided data. So it's generally in a two forms. One is the stored and another is the reflected cross-site scripting vulnerability. So what is happening in that case is that user is supplying something to the application, and without validating that or filtering out anything, application is sending it back to the user. So how this can be abused by the attacker is the XSS attack on a XSS vulnerability. That's a cross-site scripting vulnerability. So like if we see in this slide, this is a persistent cross-site scripting. Persistent means the stored cross-site scripting. What the attacker is doing, it is he will write a script and store in the database of the application. So now the victim, all the users who are visiting that website, that attacker strings will be displayed to the their browser, and their browser credential, confidential information, cookies, or any other purpose the attacker can use that cross-site scripting. So cross-site scripting is the attack which can be used for credential stealing, stealing the information, compromising the browser, and for the phishing attacks. Another attack is the SQL injection. So SQL, you may be aware about, is a structured query language, and the SQL is used for a communication language between the web application and the database. So if we need to get some data from database, we can write that in SQL, and if you want to retrieve or store some data, we can use the SQL. So what the attacker is doing can cause, if the SQL injection vulnerability is there in a web application, that the attacker can bypass the authentication. So username, password is there, but attacker can bypass that check. Attacker can dump the complete database, can steal the sensitive information from the web application database. So how it works, if you see that, suppose for an example, this is one of the example, that there is a query which is selecting the username and a password, validating the username and a password from the in the database. So select asterisk from the user table name, and where username is this and password is this. So suppose this query is used for the validation of a username and a password from the database. So what the attacker can do, instead of supplying username and a password in a login page, attacker can inject something like this, or 1 is equal to 1, and then hash or a dash dash. These are the comment characters. So effective query will be something else. It will be select asterisk and then code, or 1 is equal to 1. Since 1 is equal to 1 is always true, the database will return true, and web application will believe that let this user be in. So attacker will be inside the application without supplying username password. The thing is that attacker is able to control and modify the SQL query. Now database is executing the query of an attacker. So attacker is injecting his string into the SQL statements. So that's the SQL injection attacks. This example what we discussed was a simple one. There are tools available for conducting automated SQL injections and dumping the complete database of the web application. Remote file inclusion. So remote file inclusion is another attack in which attacker can include the remote malicious file to the victim server. So suppose the application is vulnerable to remote file inclusion. So what attacker will do, attacker will include a malicious remote file. Those files are known as generally the web shells, So web cells will be included, and in by including the web cell or a remote code or a remote file to the victim machine, attacker can control that web application and web server. He can execute the command, he can change the home page of that application and causing the defacement, and can do other type of a damage to that application. So web cells, so a screenshot of a, this is a web cell. So web cells are a malicious program, a backdoor that is a favorite choice of an attacker to upload into the weak web application or include in remote file inclusion. So if this web cell is included, the victim system will provide the complete control to the attacker. OS command injection attack. Sometimes in web applications, some queries, some commands are used, system commands are used, OS commands are used, because that's the requirement of the that web application. So now if your web application is not validating the input, so what attacker can do? Attacker can execute the malicious command by using the functionality provided by your web application. So that's the OS command injection. So attacker modify that, that's known as a command injection. So attacker modify your commands and execute his commands onto the, that's the weakness of a code. Another category, another attack is the cross-site request forgery. So in cross-site request forgery, like you may be aware about, like when you are going to your browser, you are opening the multiple tab. You are going to say the Google website on one tab, another say you are going to the xyz.com. So suppose there is a xyz.com is having a malicious content. And malicious content is something like the, say, a action of changing the password of a Google. So what can happen? So you will click on that link, or you are visiting that in another tab. The request will go to the that Google server or your email server, and it will ask to the change the password. Now that server will think that and trust this, that since a request is coming from you, so you are changing the password. But that's not true. That request was generated by xyz.com. And so by that way, attacker is able to change the password. So this is only example. Google and Gmails are not vulnerable to these CSRF because they are using the better protection. But the example is that the attacker can do action on your behalf, like a logout, sell some data, do some important transaction on your behalf from the another website. So when you are visiting multiple websites, that and your main website is vulnerable to CSRF, then attacker can exploit that vulnerability by initiating action on victim's behalf. Insufficient logging and monitoring. This is recently included into the OSP 2017 top 10. And what it says that all the web application developed should have a logging and monitoring capability. So generally the web applications, as we discussed, is not security, is not a concern and a priority. So definitely these logging and monitoring features are not enabled there. So it should be there, logging and monitoring features should be there, so that we can monitor for the attacks, we can log them, we can take the actions to improve the security of the web application. Here we will see some of the myths. So SSL protect the web application. What is the SSL? SSL is the what you see in HTTPS. So what is the purpose of the SSL? So the purpose is to protect the communication channel, not the web application. So it will only encrypt the communication from end to end, from your browser to the web application. It will not protect the web application from the other attacks and the vulnerability of a web application. Another is the firewall protect the web application. So firewall is a parameter security device. It's an on-off switch. You can allow one port or block the port. So if you are saying that you are allowing the web application, you have to allow that port 80. So the firewall, network firewall cannot protect the against that thing, because you are allowing that at a port 80 or a 443. User will follow the rule. Sometimes you think that in web application we will write you have to provide an 8-character password, so user will follow that rule. The user will follow the rule, but the attacker will not follow the rule. Even they will look for bypassing the rules set up by you. Network security scanner found no vulnerability. There are a vulnerability scanners which looks for a scan for a vulnerability. So network security scanner are for the networks or infrastructure security. Web application security scanners are different. So we should scan from the web application security scanner for the vulnerabilities in web application. We have annual security audits, so our web application is safe. So that may happen. We need a continuous monitoring and continuous security audit of the web application. Only once in a year is not sufficient, because the threat, new threats may emerge, new vulnerabilities are discovered on a daily basis that can make our web application vulnerable. So what is the countermeasures for securing the web application? The first thing is the security built-in. Security should not be the add-on feature. You should not add security over once the application, web application is built. What you have to do, you have to consider security as integrated features from the very beginning of application development lifecycle. So that's a secure software development lifecycle that should be followed. Secure coding practices, secure design deployment practices should be followed for the web application security. There are resources available, as we already discussed. OWASP resources, security guide, auditing guides, OWASP top 10 is there. So these things and resources you can use to protect the web application. So OWASP top 10 application security risk 2017 is there. It discuss about injection flaws, like we discussed SQL injection is a one type of a injection flaw. It talks about the broken authentication, where authentication is not properly implemented. It talks about the sensitive data exposure, when the sensitive confidential data, passwords of say users are exposed. It talks about the XXE attacks. It talks about the broken access control. There is a difference between authentication and access, you may be aware about. And the access control is that when the logged in users and user can bypass what the roles assigned to him and permission assigned to him. There are another is the security misconfigurations when during the deployment and during the configuration of web application, there is a security misconfiguration. Cross-site scripting, we already discussed. This deserialization attack, insecure deserializations, when there is a possibility of an attack, like in a Java serialization of objects are implemented. So if that is not implemented properly, there is a possibility of exploiting that features. Another category is using components with non-vulnerability. Sometimes we are using plugins, CMS and other plugins and features for our web application. We are integrating them. So what that can bring, if it is a vulnerable, that can bring vulnerabilities to our system that can be exploited by the attacker. Insufficient logging and monitoring, we already discussed that. The application should have a sufficient logging and monitoring features. So in summary, what we have discussed in this session is the web application security is important. It's our responsibility. It should be built in within a web application. We should follow the secure software development life cycles. We discussed some of the myths of web application security, and we have seen some attacks on the web application. So that's all for this session. Thank you.